Hello, hello. Okay, there we go. Now that's working. Okay, sorry about that. I was having problems with the stream, but now things seem to be working. So I'm going to continue on from this new video. First, I am going to quickly open up YouTube and reshare the video link out. Hello, hello. Okay, there we go. Now that's working. Okay. Sorry about all that. Alright. Oh, sorry. Didn't mean to do that. Let's move that window for me.
Take the path east of here. Gaze into the pond. The frog knows of a lost forlorn.
It's a really cute little game.
Barely visible through the murky water was the shadow of something hiding, and on a small pier with barely a sound, a lonely fisherman sat.
Hmm.
The Ember was curious. Where did you... I'm headed for the crossroads. It's not far, I think. I've heard there's a nest there. A safe place. The Ember was curious. Where did you wake up? I'm headed for the crossroads.
Okay, so you're not saying anything new.
There's a nest there. A safe place. The stranger was trapped, caught in a maze. It was hard to make sense of this place.
Thank you. I see what to do here. Okay, let's put that back on there. That all the way up. Now I can do that. I figured it out now. You gotta go there.
The stranger's voice was hoarse. I just need some time, I think, to see things clearly. The ember was curious.
I've heard
there's a nest there, a safe place. The fisherman murmured quietly between sorrowful breaths. The fisherman felt so useless. His former joys were hollow. Sitting out there every day by the pond. Only the dark water to hear him talk. In that darkness, a glimmer flickered. A thought beating like a drum. A thought that went round and round. All started with a frog. Every day by the pond, a constant reminder. Emma couldn't hold on. For a brief moment, the fisherman struggled to speak. He looked at Embo, hopeful. The fisherman spoke softly. There's a frog in that pond. Saw him grow from a tadpole. We were friends of a sort. Spent every day side by side. So much better at fishing than me, that frog is. Catches them before I can bait them. Oh, it makes me feel useless some days. The fisherman sighed. I've wasted so much time feeling like this. The old man looked carefully at the pond, at their rod, at Ember. Well, listen to me here, rambling on and on. It helps, though, telling someone. Thank you, Ember. If you need help catching anything, you just ask. Poor little worms. They didn't ask to be here. But how do you fish without them? One for me, one for the fishes. Slurp them down. You saw the frog? Did the frog mention me? You ask the frog about me. See what they say. Actually, no. Just Please don't tell the fog how much I talk about them. I chased old Blue Betty round this pond for years. Best days of my life catching that fish. Had to use myself as bait. Stuck on me head ever since. They say catching a fish isn't the point, so I tell myself that. I tell myself that a lot.
Goodbye.
If you need help catching anything, you just ask. The frog stared at Embo, its belly rumbling. Its eyes were fixed on Embo, but it seemed to mean no harm. Was this the frog that the fisherman spoke of? Embo could hardly ignore the rumbling from the frog's belly. The frog stared at Embo, its belly rumbling. The frog stared at Embo, its belly rumbling. Its eyes were... Was this the frog? Embo could hardly ignore the rumbling from the frog's belly. The frog stared at Embo, its belly rumbling.
We're gonna do this one more time.
Its eyes were... Was this the frog that the... Embo could hardly ignore the rumbling from the frog's belly.
Let's go talk to the fisherman again.
If you need help catching anything, you just ask. If you need help catching anything, you just ask. The frog stared at Embo, its belly rumbling. Its eyes were... Was this the frog? Embo could hardly ignore the rumbling from the frog's belly. If you need help catching anything, you just ask.
I do. I need you to help me with the frog. But I don't understand how.
The traveler said, "You sailed in here. Where's your boat? Friend, you need a boat. Go see the builder in the caves. Tell them I'm sorry I never came back." The stranger had blazed their own path. Created their own rock, their own islands. They did not need Ember's kindness. But still, Ember stayed. Building a bridge, should it ever be needed. The stranger met Ember's eyes. The two shared a moment of silence. The stranger met Ember's eyes. The two shared a moment of silence. If you need help catching anything, you just ask.
Yeah. I know. I need to catch something for the frog. But I don't understand how to ask you to do that.
The frog stared at Ember, its belly rumbling. Its eyes were fixed. Was this the frog? Ember could hardly ignore the rumbling from the frog's belly.
Surely that has to be up. Let's go back.
The ghost said, "Speak, and I will listen."
See.
Step backwards, little Ember. Look behind. Upon a small grassy cliff rests a forlorn.
Yeah, I know he's there. I just don't know how to get to there. Aha, this might get me to him.
The traveler spoke. "You ever had roast frog, friend?" "I miss a good roast frog. Oh, how they crackle." The stranger had been forgotten. They tried to follow as best they could. The stranger looked at Ember with surprise. "Someone came back for me. Thank you." The stranger looked at Ember with surprise. "Someone came back for me. Thank you." The door was sealed shut.
I don't understand what those mean. What else are you going to tell me?
The ghost said, "Speak and I will listen. Take the path east of here, gaze into the pond. The frog knows of a lost forlorn."
But I can't talk to the frog.
The frog stared at Embo, its belly rumbling. Its eyes were fixed. Was this the frog that Embo could hardly ignore the rumbling from the frog's belly? If you need help catching anything, you just ask. If you need help catching anything, you just ask.
Okay, figure this out. I have to do something with you, frog, but I don't know what it is. Where did you know I need to do there?
If you need help catching anything, you just ask. The old gate was locked. The crow held its shining trophy tight. The cave entrance was overgrown with dry brambles. The broken net hung ominously around the skeleton's neck. The stranger shivered in the cold. They'd moved through such dark places. They lay down and closed their eyes. Was a distant memory stolen by the passing miles. The stranger blinked at Embo. Is it morning already? How long have I been asleep? The stranger whispered, "Ever feel like you are being watched? I've never felt that. What does it feel like? Is it nice? It sounds nice."
This game is really sweet.
The worm looked helpless, with no way to escape. As Ember picked it up, the worm let out a little yelp. Inside was a scrap of journal. The strangers on the water went on without me. Where have I landed? Vines and thorns stretch out to trip me. He was nestled between the reeds, but it was just out of reach. The Wanderer's Diary. Unfamiliar trees, a path overgrown. Is this a resting place? A place between places? I call out, but mine is the only voice.
Let's go see if I can get the fisherman to catch a fish.
The fisherman noticed the broken net Ember was carrying. Let me have a look. See what? With a silk thread, the fisherman carefully knotted it together. With each knot he tied, a net began to form. Here you go. Good as new. If you need help catching anything, you just ask.
Maybe I can feed the worm to the frog.
The frog stared at Embo, its belly rumbling. Was not how Ember had imagined the end. The gurgling of water, a deafening heartbeat. But then... the fog returned Ember's good deed by leading them to a lost forlorn.
Oh, thank you.
The stranger stood alone. Their friends have fallen aside, retreating from what came next. The stranger had ventured on, now they were deep in the woods. It felt so pointless. The stranger spoke hesitantly. Is the campfire crowded? Let me gather myself. I'll see you there. Ember found the wanderer's diary. The oily smell of frogs. They know more than they will say. They watch me watching them.
Nope, nothing there. Okay.
The stranger spoke. You look hungry, friend. You bring any broth with you? There's a cook in the swamp. Makes a broth like you wouldn't believe. Keep telling them that it doesn't taste right. They'll keep giving you more.
You're only missing the one. I think I'll just finish off the forest tonight and then continue on another time.
Was nest, but it was just out of reach. The old gate was locked. Ember placed the key in the lock and slowly began to turn it. stranger gasped for breath. Dark water sweeping above their head.
Will the water come up if I pick him up?
The sea didn't care if they sank or swam. Slowly the tides ebbed, washing over old walls. Safe harbor emerging from the inky depths. Amber reached out a hand. Stranger, look down. The ground feels good beneath my feet, friend. The ghost said, "You have done all you can, little one. Your journey lies ahead. Little one, your journey ahead will not be easy. The path to leave this place is blocked. I will guide others to follow after you clear the way." There are others like me who can help. You will always be welcome here in the forest.
Well, thank you for joining me for this first part of the Last Campfire.
Once again,
I hope to
Ember
continue it later.
Feel eyes watching.
Sorry for my stream messing up earlier on, but things seem to have been working now. And so, yeah, I hope you enjoyed it.